Hello everyone, and welcome to New Modern Video. We're playing the deck that I brewed last week with Sire of Seven Death. That video went very well, so I'm gonna play this deck again. Funnily enough, this week I was with the Car Market guys and we recorded a non-balanced Modern video, and I built this deck with Once Upon a Time and Ayubugin, and I think that Glaring Fleshraker is just a broken card. It's really very strong, just kills you so quickly if you have fast mana, which, you know, Ayubugin gives you. I also really like Eldrazi Linebreaker. Sire of Seven Death replaces No Drifter in this list. It is very good against normal decks once you resolve it. It's not good against combo decks, but for example, I remember that video against Boros was a house. It's 7 drop, so you can pitch it to the Ugin's Labyrinth, and it discounts to the Eldrazi end. It's an Eldrazi, so it discounts to the Eldrazi Temple as well. So it has all the synergies, and the word pay 7 life, while it's very bad in the Eldrazi ramp deck, it is much better here because we're pressuring our opponent with the various Mimic, the Eldrazi end, Fleshraker, Linebreaker, and so on. So this is... This deck is really cool. Really, really cool. Lots of MH3 cards that made it playable again, I would say. Alright, we are on the draw. This hand is strong. We have Devourer of Destiny, which will give us, hopefully, the Eldrazi Temple. This way I can go turn two Thanos here. Let's go. Still refacing, no companion, so it's not Boros. Oh, Belcher. Mm-hmm. Okay. It's not Eldrazi Temple, so either I get greedy and just exile all of this, hoping to find an Eldrazi Temple. Which obviously is just one, you also don't have Ayubugin, like in Nobelis Modern. Or I get that Prismatic Vista and just accept that. I think I'm gonna be greedy and just say no, exile 4, and take a draw. Drawing this 7 drop means that I can also draw another Ugin's Labyrinth to play turn 2 Thanos here. You bought Italian FBV Lanera Elves and Lightning Bolts? Well done, well done. Well done. Very good, very good purchase. How was the Great Trespasser? Bringing the previous league? Not great, not great. I did not win much. And let's see if they play one of their 2 drop. They don't. Unable to scream main deck, interesting. This only exiles creatures, though. It doesn't exile enchantment, unfortunately. I don't have a play. I'll pass and go Cosex Command X equal 1 later. What's Lightning Bolt in Italian? Fulmine. I'm pretty sure I know all the FBB football in Spanish. Spanish is Relampago, in French is Foudre, in German is, shit, I don't know. What's in German, Lightning Bolt? I don't think I've ever seen one. Oh, I did, actually, yeah, Blitzschlag, that's true. Blitzschlag, yeah, I did see that, I just forgot. Alright. Let's go for a cake, man. I mean, it's not amazing, but I feel like I need to curve out. Oh, there it is. That's Ugin's Labyrinth. You were hiding. Last turn would have been insane. Annaccia. I'll probably bottom this at this point. Last turn would have been insane if we'd gone Taunus here into Taunus here. And then this for much more. Ooh, Linebreaker. Well, let me go Prismatic Vista because, you know, I may just run out of lands to grab. I don't think forest matters because the only thing that's at forest isn't the sideboard. We gotta waste. I'll go Thonuts here because if they resolve the card, it's very bad. In Portuguese, it's Raio. That's true. Layer of Denial. Okay. Yeah. Flare of Denial, that's such a powerful combo. Trainier for something and then Flare of Denial. They go Belcher, little I can do. Just on top and lose. No, they don't even have a fourth land, wow. Okay. This would be a great draw last turn. Ah, kind of like drawing exactly one after everything. Okay. So they have mana up. It means to me that they may have another Flare of Denials. I'm just playing the least powerful one here. Well, obviously they can ignore this and keep the Flare for Thonuts here. Yeah. Definitely an unfortunate series of draws. But that's okay. 3 mana, 6-3 haste, trample. Not bad. What's that? Oh, Weary Invention. Okay. Yeah. Your Weary Invention for Lotus Bloom. Mm-hmm. I have this member for the, no, what's it called? Tameshi. It's the second league. We did very well with the first league with this deck. Trying it again. Component keeps on playing Source to Plowshares. Very strong. Yeah, 3 white, they're doing it. So yeah, happy about the dismember. They can still play Belcher though here, so it's still a big problem to do that. Dismember. 3 cards in it, one is the Sink into Stupor. Yeah, so again, if they go Belcher now, I can't do anything. Maybe there was a world in which it was better to go Thonuts here instead of Linebreaker. I just thought they had Flare Denial up mana. But they just had the Weird Invention mana, which also makes sense. So yeah, let's hope they don't have Belcher. Oh, Baying Coast. So they still have the Sink into Stupor mana up. Sorry, card in end. Yeah, they don't have it. Good. Good news. Draw. Devour of Destiny, not good. I'll play Thonuts here. Hard in hand is at least an only one. So what's the other one? I can crack this to placing into Stupor, but I don't think it's that good of a play. Yeah. Mandir, this will be a rush of inspiration. Draw 2 cards, then discard a card at random. So you don't care about Commandeer. Which one of these do I want to draw his card? Maybe just Rash of Inspiration? Yeah, I don't think Sink into Stupor does anything relevant if they just bounce. I think I just don't want them to find the combo. Yeah, I don't have any attacker, so I pass. The Veritas and he can destroy this, unable to scream next turn. If I find a land. Okay, they're placing it to super. Obviously, I die on the spot if they find Belcher, but you know, it is what it is. Fleshbreaker. I don't do much with it, so I just attack. And pass. Just play this and pass. Hey, what's this? Flare Denial. Weird that I shocked. So I win the game if I draw land. Your promise Murktide? Yeah, we played it. It's gonna be on Sunday on the YouTube channel. And I draw Tameshi. Hey. Right on time. The card for the win. Not a win, but it's probably very good because of the Sigurd Restoration. We'll see. They also drew a card, so, you know, could have drawn the Belcher. Sometimes you go all in on that Sigurd Restoration, you just lose all your land, you know? Are they doing something? Not yet. Not yet. It's pretty crazy how strong it is, unable to scream. Just turning the card into a 0-2 instead of a 1-1 makes an incredibly big difference. Like, when you, you know, like, turn to frog type of cards, 1 mana make it 1-1, or never really modern playable, but this one turning into a 0-2. Just makes that like 5 or 6 damage different. Okay, they drew. When did they draw Belcher? Oh, with Sigurd Resto. Yeah, okay. Alright, we are dead. Yeah, playing Drew Tameshi at a very important moment and beat us. We would have drawn next turn a land to play the Hour of Destiny and kill this. Okay, now we have Battlescape. Sorry, Waterscape Battle Mage. We have Disruptor Flute, and I don't think I want Training Sphere. Definitely don't want the All This Dust. I'll keep in the Dismember. Actually, I'm cutting the All This Dust. I know that gives me less options for the Labyrinth Ugin, but I think it's fine. Need to cut 4 more cards. I think I'll cut Kozef's Command. I don't know if it's like a bomb, but I feel like I want everything else that I have here. Guten Morgen. Yeah, double able to scream is very good. And it's not even like a popular card unable to scream in the main deck. It's usually a cyber card. Strong. It doesn't have much disruption, but yeah, it's a good end. Lotus Bloom. Okay. Red and colorless. Yeah, it isn't, it's not disruptive, but it is very fast. Nah, Badger was not always such a meme. When it came out, it was a super powerful deck. And now with all the spell land, it is definitely one of the best. Remain one of the best deck in the format. Damage four. Okay. Oh, wow. Okay, let's just play Thawnuts here. Yeah, that's exactly what I needed. There's not really much you can do about this. Like, Solidity is the only one I can think of. All right. Let's go on the race here. I'm attacking you for 9 now. And then you die the next turn, right? So I think. Huh. Funny, because you have both Baim Vale and Sink into Stupor that disrupt me from winning next turn. Hello, Bayan. How's the videos with Car Market guys going? It's over. We did them all. It was a lot, but it's over. And later today, after lunch, we're gonna go to Rome. Anyway, let's go back to this. So if they kill me, it's gonna be on turn 4, but I can kill them on my turn 4. So now I threaten 9 damage, so you're at 7. I don't think Baim Vale saves you. I think I'm just taking Sink into Stupor here. I guess you can go Tameshi. You. Nah, I think Tameshi is you still lose. So yeah, I'm gonna take Sink into Stupor. And it, I mean, I was just attacking for so much that I don't even know if I put it as any outs. Maybe their out is the creature, the 2 mana creatures. Yeah. I'm not sure if they have any good plays. Probably not. I probably thought too much into it. My curve is just too big. Like my curve against no removal spell is just too strong. Obviously, if they play against the Aquifatal Push and such, my curve gets easily disruptive. Okay, they have Baim Vale, but again, like we just do this now and it's 1 million damage. Or even that. Why not? All right, 1 billion damage coming over. I don't even want to count. Okay, let's go game three. Now, do I want to bring back the All This Dust to give me more consistency? With the Ugin's Labyrinth. I think maybe Wastekeep Battle Mage is bad. Although, this card gives me the out in case my opponent goes. In case my opponent goes Belcher. Alright, I'll cut one and one. It's this one of All This Dust that will change. Yeah, put Gemstone Cavern in. Please, please, Magical Line. Do it in time. Okay, thank God. Oof. Sorry. Yeah, forgot. Also, if you watched the last video with Gemstone Cavern, it was kind of broken. Like we open it every single game. Not every single game, but most of the games we were in the draw. Okay, happy with this hand. It has two Eldrazi Temple, which isn't as good as an Ancient Tomb, but I can't cast Disruptor Flute on turn one, but it's alright. I'd love to draw Ogin's Labyrinth. Ogin's Labyrinth is probably better than an Eldrazi Temple. Okay, the mouth is six. Okay, I can even do turn two Line Breaker now. Why not Soulless Jailer? Huh. Soulless Jailer, you're saying. Oh, yeah. Yeah, maybe Soulless Jailer would have been good too. Yeah. Win more burn. Thank you for the seventh month. Welcome to the stream. All right. I kind of want to deck thin. Yeah, I'll deck thin. Mountain. All right, let's get aggressive here. Line Breaker, boom. Yeah, so the problem with Sidon in... Oh, wow, Disruptor Shore pitching Rush of Inspiration. Huh. The problem with Sidon in Jailer is that I'm already Sidon in Flute. Like, I don't want to dilute my gameplay too much. But yeah, no, maybe it would have been very good, yeah. Okay, opponent plays a 2-drop, Pelagi. Okay, let's hope they don't find a... Okay, they don't. Also, where's my Cavern of Souls? Just making sure. Is it in the deck? Okay, it is. No, because I haven't drawn it yet. I was wondering. Yeah, so All This Dust is not good. I'm never going to say it's good. But you know what I mean. Like, All This Dust can pitch Tugin's Labyrinth until you can have busted plays, busted draws. Ooh, Flesh Raker. Man, I love to play Flesh Raker early. Although now I think I should just go Thaw, not Seer. Yeah, if this was like Anugin's Labyrinth and I could have double spelled, it would have been great, but it's not. That's okay. Can't complain too much about going Thaw, not Seer, tapping two lands. Now, your three cards are Wyrmwood Invention and two more. If you have Flare, hey, okay, you also have Flare. Okay, you don't have Flare. That's good. Char Belcher. Actually, ignore Char Belcher here and take Weir. Because if you go Land Char Belcher, I can just Flute it after, so... There's no Land's Eye Diamond in this format. So just take Weir, which is a little bit suspect. You know. You do. Alright, I have one card in hand. I'm just gonna play Flute. And then if they have a counter, I'll play another Flute. Buongiorno, Matte. Let's play a Flute. Naming Goblin Char Belcher. And now, I think I can play Flesh Raker, because if they answer the Flute, they can't activate the Belcher. Spaghetti Monster, yes. Actually, a very long first match. I don't know, usually this deck is super quick. If I do the opposite, why didn't you do the opposite? If I do the opposite and the counter Flute, I lose the game. I hope that was... the answer that you needed. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, it is Endless Gas. Yeah. For sure. It was a very good end. Pelagi, they milled Shoal and Weir. Could have attacked first. If they blocked, there was no counter spell. You're right. I could have attacked first. You're right. Yeah. You're right. They chose Disruptive Shoal. Okay, so they have two cards. One is Disruptive Shoal. Mm-hmm. All right. Now. I So, I could go Sarah 7 Death. I could do that. So what you got there? You got Disruptive Shoal. Disruptive Shoal is pretty bad. But is there a world in which they bounce my flute end of turn with a card? What is even Brazen Borrower, I guess? Yeah. Yeah, I'm just gonna play safe and just do these two things first. Also, like, if I go Mimic and then Sire, it's the same. Like, it's a 7-7. Mimic is a 7-7. Wojonos here. Into the Flood Maw, yeah. Yeah, so I'm just gonna play Mimic, tapping one land, make a token, ping you. And then, you know, we'll hold this up and, I'm just doing my opponent turn. Ping you again. This card pings a lot. End of turn, I'll play Flute, and then I'll play Sarah 7 Death, which will pump. Do I remember the Gavincha Betch we played as a kid? No, I don't. I don't have memories actually about Shabrajar as a kid. What was it? What were we doing? Flute again the same Belcher. I don't care. I mean, I can technically flute the Tameshi. Maybe that. Nah, I just flute the Belcher. Ah, oh, you go Shoal? Okay, how much damage do you take now? Take one here, you go to 10. I played this. This is a 7-7. You take two, you go to 8. You're not dead. This one doesn't have haste. Maybe you should play Arena of Glory. Nah, that's not true. Oosh! Aspetta un attimino. Ce la faccio? I think so. I think I can do it all. Right? 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Yes. Alright, that's it. That's lethal. We could do it all. Basically, anytime you see this deck having a lot of permanents and you don't think it's lethal, it's lethal. This one doesn't have haste. I think if you replace Lifelink with haste, it's probably worse anyway. No, maybe not. Anyway, this is becoming 3-3. Sure, why not? And then I'll play Sire of 7 Death. Go line. Hello? Can I sacrifice my spawn? Hello? Okay. Okay. Ping, ping. Mimic becomes a 7-7 now. Landbreaker gives this plus million haste and attack for 45. Alright. First match is over. Again, last league we played with this deck, we lost the final to Neoform. We were 4-0, and then we lost to Neoform. It's not that Magical Line lags, I just, I don't know. In that moment, it did. It's fine. I have much more problems with Arena than on Magical Line. Magical Line requires very little out of your computer. Speaking of which, Viano, I see you in the chat. Viano, I need help. I need to buy a computer. As you remember, the days where I said that I was moving, they're actually coming. It's happening. And I need to buy a computer. One that doesn't lag when I play Magic Arena would be the best. That's my only That's my only requirement. I can play Magic Arena on my computer. It's currently with this one, I can't. You don't trust yourself? Ah! Then who do I trust? I trust you more than anyone else. Alright, this hand is a keep. I have the Devourer of Destiny. You will receive a Ugin's Labyrinth top of my deck and curve out perfectly. What's my budget? I don't know. I would say around between one beta balance and one. I don't know. So I love to spend a lot of money on Magic cards, but I hate to spend a lot of money on anything else. That is my life. Okay, so I was not able to find Ugin's Labyrinth or Rose's Temple, which is fine, since those are the best. I think I'm happy with the Prismatic Vista. Not that I'm very happy with the Prismatic Vista, I'm normally happy. Then, what's my play? I think I'll play a Drezzen Mimic. It's just much worse than other odds at the end, I think. And I'm like, my opponent's likely to kill it. Mangu editing? No, I don't do that. I don't do that. I only need to play Magic Arena. That's it. That's the only thing I need to do with my computer. Because the stream goes on anything. Stream Magic Online goes on anything. This computer is like 10 years old. The only thing that it can't do is play Magic Arena and stream. Arbinger Q, thank you for the Prime. Alright. E Dual Land! No! Va bene lo stesso. Prismatic Vista. I need a land. Deck, listen to me. You have to give me a land next turn. Otherwise, I lose. Arena runs pretty terribly on high-end systems. Okay, I have no idea what that is. It sounds like... Actually, it doesn't sound anything. I don't know what it is. Magic Arena, Resolu Marina. I don't know what's Resolu Marina, but no, it's Magic Arena. The video game with the little bugs that walk around where you pay money and you get things that stay on the client that you can't actually cash out. You know, that video game that you can play on your phone in the bathroom. But yeah, as a streamer, you're required to stream at the computer. Seven Bombe. No. Laptop. I'm against laptop. I have one. I never use it. I want a normal computer that sits there and, you know, it's good. I had a laptop to stream and then it just burned. And they said, no, you shouldn't stream a laptop. Okay. Leyline Binding. Hey, justo. This is very good. All right, I need to draw land now. Deck, give me land. If you don't give me land, I lose. Thank you, deck. PKS, probably still not good enough, but whatever. We're in it. Drawing 7 drop without against Labyrinth is not ideal. Your advice would be to look for a good brand with a nice streamer support in exchange for advertisement. No. I don't exchange for advertisement. They want to advertise me, they give me money. Not goods. Not a dog. Also, I don't really ask for money to advertisements. What do I take here? So, ideally, they never draw land to play Sand Drake. If they do, I lose. I'll take the Kabu. Assembled were lap... No, I don't like laptops. I don't like laptops. First thing that you have to understand once you're a content creator is that you need to get paid with money. That is the first thing. Okay. Weird. I just blocked Nakato. I'm at 5. Ma poi ne attendo, è un attimo che muore. No, come Pult. You drew Bolt? Ma vaffanculo. I think I lose. I think I lose this game. 2K? 2000 euro? I guess. Attenzione. Attenzione. We'll lose yet. Ugin's Labyrinth was like the dream draw here. Okay, I also have 6 mana, so I can play. Allora. Your annual. Okay, so I survive now, right? I survive now, and then I have to draw one of these. Sire 7 Death has reach as well. How does that die? Yeah, but you know, if you buy a beta balance, you have a beta balance for your life, and you can tell everyone, I have a beta balance. If you buy a computer, you have a computer. You know, everyone has that. So, you know, the money spent on a beta balance are better spent. Anyway, we have to choose now. I have to big decisions. I think I'll take the Devourer of Destiny under the Labyrinth because if I gem this, I think I win. So I'm gonna play this one and this one. Wasn't that a computer store? Well, I went to Unieuro, but I didn't have any computer assembled. But now with Black Friday, I was hoping that, you know, that would be like that would do some deals. Some pre-made deals for the people who know nothing like me. This becomes a 5-5. Look at that! A 5-5! A 6-6! Wow! Chat, look at this last look at this rule. I actually did this yesterday on Mango's Workshop. If I edit a Drowsy and I play a creature, it comes into play as a 5-5, and Mimic becomes a copy of a 5-5, so that's cool. Alright, now, what's my next play? They attack with this, I block, and they attack with this, I chump. It's alright. If they draw land to play Sion, am I dead on board? If I attack? I think I'm dead on board anyway, so might as well attack. Yano, what do you say? No, I don't want to do that, Viano. That's unreasonable. That's unreasonable. I don't wanna be around and asking people for money in exchange of advertisement. I don't care. I'll spend the money. It's fine. Okay, we're not dead here. Mifcom. They sell pre-built PC and deliver to EU countries. Oh, interesting, interesting. So if I block, I'm say F4, yeah. Oh, attenzione! Chat! I don't need to chump. Oh no, spet, I win, right? No, block like this dies. Alright, I don't need to chump, I can go to 1. If I didn't attack with this, I would have chumped with this, it would have been better. Allora, maybe I just block this one then. Yeah. I think like this is good. I just win by playing Sire 7 Death. Dai, andiamo a uno. I die to Lightning Bolt, but whatever. If that Lightning Bolt is good anyway. Yeah. Mifcom, I'll tap it down. Ifcom. Maybe he shouldn't have attacked. Maybe he shouldn't have attacked. Push. Vado a push proprio a caso. A caso push. Who plays push in zoo? Anyway. Just give me a land. Deck with a land, we win. Without a land, we lose. Now, it's not guaranteed even with a land. With that one, we lose for sure. Mannaggia me. If I didn't attack, Ah, oh, it would have been so good. And niente, I lose. I don't have seven. They, if I didn't attack and chumped and block, I would have traded this. And now I would have played this one in face of a Ragavan. I would have been in a good shape. Could have played 0 and 7 that last turn. Only on paper. Unfortunately, Magical Line, we could have not. But yeah, if I didn't attack, I think we could have won this. Rip Eroni. Okay, now we are on the play. On the play, we have all his dust. Four. Well, everything seems good. I don't want to cut any of these cards. A land. Who needs lands anyway? Not read all the questions out loud. She's not easy. It's not easy. It's like the impulse to read out loud what you're reading, you know? Okay, can I find a dual land? Eccole lì, bellissime, belle. Temple or Labyrinth? They're both very good. Did I set in Gems of Cavern on the play? Oh no, I've just got a main deck. Never mind. I think I'll take Temple. Eldrazi. What's my favorite canned tomato brand? Mutti, I think. Mutti. Spelled like this. Yeah, we always get Mutti. Draw Eldrazi Temple. And get in with the line. Ah, yeah, però lui, the opponent made a sketchy play there. Dark Ray with the link, amazing. Let me see. Acher Predator. 1349. That's a nice beta balance. I7. Se l'amicio stimata, 10 euro. And it arrives next week. Wait, that's your PC? Beep beep Amarabo, that's your PC? How does it work? And it's in Italian too, great. Only 500 GB said it's horrible. I don't think Intel is a good choice. Come, Intel is not a good choice. I'll see your Intel. Alright, my opponent has a removal spell, but it might be a fatal push. Allora sai come, magnate questo se fai a fatal push. She a bolt? That's fine, it doesn't go to my face. Okay. All right, let's see again this thing. Quattro. Cosa fai? Dai, ma che cazzo dici? You play White Order Phantom with this mana base. Vabbè, allora vale tutto. Maybe I should have sided in Wastegate Battle Mage. Where's my mountain? Okay. So Twitch chat doesn't like that computer? Do you have another option or just all he knows? You You tried to find what you suggested to Gab 2 months ago? Oh yeah, that's exactly what I want. Beware, Intel 14 is broken in design. Vabbè, broken, adesso. Intel, is this Intel 14? Is this number 14? Okay. Oh, we got another link. We got another link. Let's see. So costa di meno. Già qualcosa. Acer. Intel 13. I hope this is not broken in design. It also costs less. Also, I can also pick it up at the store. Wow, that's cool. Store is nearby me. What happened? You bided my thing and played another thing. E faccio qualcosina o niente? I'm gonna pick Command Exile this draw card, or I can just play this and hope it untaps. I kind of want to just play this and open untaps. I think it's really good when this plays it and open untaps. Do I recommend to buy part PC and assemble? Nah, that's not for me. That's not for me. It's like if you tell to a noob, oh, you should not net deck. You should build your own deck. No, you shouldn't. You shouldn't build your own deck. You should net deck. Yeah, Viano is the official help for every Magic streamer. He actually has the license. Allora! What do we do? I can go K-Command, take this out, make a mana. Okay, I don't need to make a mana, I just draw a card. I definitely want to take this out. And draw. Once you have the Flesh Raker out, things are easier. You think it's harder to build a deck than a computer? Oh, no, I understand. And that may be what you feel. It's not what I feel. To me... Okay, now, so I can go dismember on the brawler. That would put me to, what, 8? Attack me down to 6. No, I think I just pass. No, but honestly, like, if I could pay €1,000... Oops, I misclicked. Aspetta un attimino, let me click open again. If I could pay €1,000 and get, you know, a computer like this, and I can play Magic Arena and stream at the same time, in, you know? My only requirement. Alright, let's think about this. I like to block this guy. And I'll be taking damage for it. Now, if I draw land, I can slam this bad boy. That's an easy requirement. Bad Cook MTG, are you linking me computers? I don't know what that is. Can you stream Arena on the current PC? I can't. On a 1080, I can't. I need 7. I only need to do 720. Vaffanculo. Oh, aspetta. I could dismember the White Orchard thing, and my other thing would be alive. Eh? But then I die to a burn spell. But I think I should dismember. Yeah, I think I'll dismember. Yeah, I need to draw a dual land now to play Sire. I have 8 lands that make me play it. That, yeah, boom. Not bad. Not bad. This is a lot of damage. Like, a lot of damage. Hasty? What's hasty? Just Ragavan, so I don't die anyway. No Popper today? No Popper today. I'm dead to a flame. I'm not dead to that. It's not bad. And now I am dead. Is it first strike? It does. E niente, siamo morti. We're dead. Mannaggia. Close though, close game. I'll take a bathroom break and come back for match number 3. Don't go anywhere. Definitely not Chris. I appreciate the help. Appreciate the help. Round number 3. We have a great hand. Oh, the opponent has the Devourer of Destiny, though. What's my point of view about Serve Death Nail Lace Eldrazi? I don't have it. I don't have any point of view on that. I think it's very good here because of Ugin's Labyrinth and it's a 7 drop. But if your deck has Ancient Tomb and City of Traitors, like, I think, you know, if Ugin's Labyrinth doesn't exist, then Serve 7 Death is not a modern legal card. Sorry, it's not a modern playable card. You play here because of the strength of Ugin's Labyrinth. Okay. Okay. A little bit too many lands, unfortunately. Maybe we should attack first. But yeah, I'm making a 2-2. Makes it slightly more resilient. Grim Draw would be Line Breaker. Because I can go Flesh Raker, Floating One Colorless, make a token, Prismatic Vista Mountain, Line Breaker. That would be the dream. Okay, they draw a card, we kick a man, make a token. And they play the one ring. A trigger deals damage. And they miss the land drop, wow. Mind drawing a spell at any point? And pass. And pass. The ring prevents the damage. Let's see what they're up to. Talisman. No, come Kozilek's Return. It's too good. I guess we lose. The vibes are off. There was a lot of good vibes. I guess the computer talk put the vibes off. I think so. I think that's what happened. Brainy Whiskey Battle Mage. I'll take out 2 Dismember and 1 All Is Dust. Alright, no more computer talk. Let's focus on winning. All right, hands fine, nothing fancy, but fine. I can go against Labyrinth, put down CR7 Death, dip a flute for the ring. I'd rather lose the game to the ring than flute to the ring. Let's go. Whose Turn is a cool card, that's true. Well, let's draw one of our 8 powerful 3 drop. There it is. Let's attack first. And play Flesh Raker. Okay. The Thanatier. Deal 1, deal 2, attack for 5. And try to discard a ring. I think I'll take the Kozilek Return. Yeah. Everything else seems beatable. You're at 11. The Kozilek Command can deal a lot of damage with a Flesh Raker. Like a lot of damage. Let's see what they're up to. They can Kozilek Command the Flesh Raker now. I think it wouldn't be a bad idea. All right, they went for a key command, but wow, they took down the Idderals at the end. Huh. Surprised. The BF Gamer, thank you for the raid. Okay, draw this one. That's not bad. What do we do? So we can go key command for 4. That's going to be 5 damage. 5 damage. 5 damage, not enough. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, wow. The taking down the Idderalzia and prevented them from getting hit by the Sire. That's funny. I don't really have too many great options outside of just Kozilek Command for a bunch. How did they scry? Oh, they didn't scry. That's true. They didn't draw any card. Okay, so they chum blocked. Uh-huh. Okay, I'll do this now. Draw and make tokens. So I may draw into like Thanatseer or, you know, other cards. Now I'll deal 5 damage down to 4. And what can I do? There's another Flesh Raker. She's probably my pickup. There's also the Line Breaker. Yeah, I guess I'm just gonna bottom. Do I want to play Flesh Raker now? If I do next turn, I can go for this thing, but I don't even know if I want to. I just go Flesh Raker now. Flesh Raker dies to... I guess Flesh Raker dies to Cake Command. My opponent can go Ring. Okay, yeah, I still think I should draw both of these, but I don't want to play it. It's really bad against Cake Command. So I'll deal a lot of damage and pass. You're at 4. Go. And next turn, even if my opponent, like, K commands me now, should be good. With the attack of Thanatseer plus the other stuff I have. Looks like they can go Ring, though. 4. No, they can't go Ring. They can't go Karn and Ring. Let's see what they're up to. 4 Karn. Their plan is the bridge. It's not gonna save them. The Glaring Flesh Raker beats bridge. Yeah, that was the plan. All right, GG. Let's go game 3. Although they didn't draw the ring this game. Maybe we should have flute. Not to die to the ring. All right, we're on the draw, so I'll bring in the second Gemstone Caverns. I don't want to. They also have cards. Maybe I really should have the flute, huh? Yeah, really should have the flute. This feels so bad. Maybe the fact that I have K Command makes me not want to have like Eldrazi Mimic. I don't know though. Fancy was clutch. Yeah. Alright, so I think this ends a mulligan. I understand I have Devourer of Destiny, which can be anything, but I think I should just mulligan. This one is a 5. And then would have been insane 7, but it's a 5. So I can bottom these two and then go Cavern pitch this. So I'll bottom these two, done, and then I go Devourer and Cavern. Cavern comes in, and I pitch this. So I have 3 cards on turn 0. Well, yeah, I'm going to be very good on 7, but it is what it is. Now, reveal Devourer, and hopefully I can find a powerful 3-drop to cast on turn 1. Line Breaker, Flesh Raker, that's very good. Yeah. To do that. One card on turn 1. Pretty normal. Which of my lands were like Moxes, basically. Dismember. Okay. Dismember. All right. Let's play Thonseer, and I have no cards in hand. And one Flesh Breaker, turn two Thonseer. It's pretty strong. But yeah. Now, ideally, I take their ring and they, I don't know, don't do too much. Slash, I draw Line Breaker. Command for one, huh? Not impressed. Oh, wow. Okay, so you have nothing going on. Mm-hmm. Well, now I guess it's gonna be who draws better first. Since we have both enough lands to play, I guess, and I have a 4/4. There's no way I can cast Devourer if I guess there's a way if I draw exactly a Eldrazi Temple, but I think I'd rather just hold this here. Your soul will make a spawn, it seems. Oh no, a 7-drop you drew. Ay ay ay, what's that? Hope it's not Worldbreaker, but the Devourer instead. Let's make a spawn, okay. Well, undo destroy. Probably Eldrazi Temple is the best one to destroy. Ah, the colored land. Ah, it's actually not a bad idea. I can't draw, I can't play Linebreaker. Let's see what land they have. Do they have like Urza's Saga? No, just another temple, sure. Okay, alright, my turn. Well, this costs 11. It's arriving. The chum block, it costs 10. That's not great. It's a 4/4 though. Could have been worse. Okay, so they chum block. Now, this thing cost 10. They have 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So in 2 turns, they're able to. Hey, unfortunately, there's not much I can do. I guess the best thing I can do is drawing Kozak's Command that can exile their graveyard. That's the best thing I can do. If I had the flute that I had to mulligan down, I could have named the Emrakul. We have named Dugin's Labyrinth as well. They would have been able to return it. Yeah, next to make an Emrakul. So I need to draw Kozak's Command now if I want to win. Yeah, it's not good. Shoot 8, you return that, and you play it. So yeah. GG. The big Eldrazi beat the smaller Eldrazi. I guess there's a way to win. Yeah, maybe there's a way to win if I just never draw anything. But I guess it's pretty impossible since they're gonna chump attack with my Thought Not Seer now. Very hard indeed. All right. Draw. Hope it's just a red land. Okay, that's actually a red land. You like the opponent deck? It's called the Eldrazi Ramp. I made some videos about it. You can definitely check it out. So they return to the Devourer, then a chump attack. I like red land because it opens the door for a Landbreaker top deck. They can't really do too much this turn, so they just don't even play the land. They just draw. Now, I draw for turn, and you know if there's a Landbreaker, I'm threatening lethal, so they can't really attack. So if they just break, I, you know, there's a world where I win. It's not over. It's not Emrakul's Dionstorn. All right, I go. Not good, but okay. If they attack, it opens up top deck for Linebreaker. I only have 5 mana, but if I draw another temple, I can cast something. 13, I go to 7, okay. So we are dead next turn. Let's see if they drew something. No? Alright, Landbreaker? No? GG. GG. Close games. We multi 5, and we had a very strong start to the point I was able to stop it with the dismember. Okay, round number 4 on the draw. Not a very good end. I think I'll mulligan it. Much better. Keep bottom forest. This deck has no green card in the main. I have a strong start here. Turn 1 Linebreaker. Turn 1. Nothing. Turn 2 Linebreaker. Saracen Death can come down. Did they put a Rugen Gigantha? They did. Okay. All right, that's a good draw. I can cast it on turn 1. How's side working? I still never cast it. We lost to Zoo, where we were very close to cast it. It would have been very good, but just never was able to. Okay, Xander Langer, you know, glory. That might be again Zoo. Huh. Ragadash. Megadash, I'll block. I go for a 4-3 haste. My preview card.
Okay, Temple Garden, that gives you all the colors.
I had a very, very good curve. Red, red, green. You want Haste Kavu and Haste Raga? Oh, Haste Sion. Do you also Haste Ragavan? Strong. Very strong Arena of Glory. You revealed a land. Do you also have a Bolt for my Linebreaker? I hope not. I'm gonna do no, because, yeah. We're just beating each other out here. I think so. You don't untap that, so you don't have. I'm attacking for 8, down to 5. And this thing costs 6 now. I draw a 7 drop, I can cast it next turn.
Okay.
Oh, you don't attack anymore. Stop the clock. Flip a land. They pass. 7 drop. 7 drop, no. Right, so I think I'm gonna pump Linebreaker and attack with it. It has trample. So opponent will have to block and take 2. And this one I don't want to. I didn't expect that. Anyway, I said I don't want this to die. Because this one's gonna make me play the Sire next turn. For 7 mana. Sorry, for 6 mana. I have 5 right now. Think I drew no spells for my opening end. I can now exert again, maybe. Is this Flage? Oh, Leyline. Okay. Leyline turns this into. Yeah, so as long as they don't kill my Araldi, I'm fine. What do you exile? Linebreaker, you exile. Okay. Okay, let's go. Ooh, another one. Well, my play has to be this one. It costs one less because of this. Who doesn't have trample or anything, yeah. Okay, so this is Ward, pay 7 life, which unfortunately, because you gained 6, is now not a problem. If you didn't gain 6 with a ley line, it was like you couldn't kill this. So, if you have ley line binding, you get rid of it. If you don't have ley line binding, in combat, this thing seems to be winning. First strike, Hexproof, lifelink, trample, vigilance. Oh, trouble flames, never mind. There's no combat involved. I'm gonna side this in. Last game I didn't side it in. I think it was a mistake. I think I'm cutting Mimic. It's just weak. It's probably good in the solitary matchup, but in the interactive matchup it seems like a very weak card. You didn't see that coming? Well, Trouble Flames is definitely a common way to die. We mimicked a Sire yet in this league. Yes, actually, I did that. I did that in one game against Belcher. This hand is a mulligan. And it is also a mulligan, unfortunately. All right, let's keep this. Now, what do we bottom? This and... What if I bottom Thanatsir, just rely on all his dust to do its work? I think so. Arena of Glory is that. You don't have any red mana. I mean, you could change your mana base entirely, but... I want to say no to this. I need to draw powerful lands to be able to compete. I need to draw dual lands, double lands, to be able to compete. I lost connection to the game. Okay, so what we could do in the meanwhile, while we wait, is trying to come up with some plans for the Poppergeddon deck I want to play. Is the one inspired to the one that Piagonti gave me. It's this Jund control deck. I want to do the cyber plans. It gave me a little bit of cyber plan, but I changed a few cards, so I want to make sure that it works. Actually. Alright. Seems like my opponent's back. Alright, my opponent's back. Flawless Trend Go. Mm-hmm. And go. Okay, so it goes down the lounge. I think Mill will have addition one day, some days, maybe. I mean, there's Fracture Sanity damage too. My opponent is not really playing. I mean, they'll probably beat me, but just very, very slowly. Okay. Abu? You wanna fetch? No, not really. Let's see what I draw. Okay, that's not bad. Fortunately, the Lawbreaker lines up pretty badly against that thing. So we can't really attack with a 4/3. That's not great. This one can only bounce, but with blue mana. Actually, maybe... No, I need to draw land anyway. So, I need a colorless mana. So, maybe I shouldn't have got Mountain. Should I get Waste? But, like, any land now is colorless in my deck, so... In order to bounce, I'll need to draw land anyway. Oh, it's funny. My opponent probably set it in Char Maw because they have no Giganta and I just got two basics. And the game, this game will mull to 5, so my draw is not great. Not great. Alright. Let's try and play this and let's see what happens. Although we have 6 cards in hand. It's like a disenchant, the binding. Iron of Glory is so good in Zoo. They can give haste to two different creatures now. Well, if they had Scion, I would have played it last turn. We don't have it. Lip bloom. Oh wow, they don't give it haste. Surprising. No blocks. That's it. Gonna concede and drop the league. GG, we have been defeated. If last video with this deck went very well, this one kind of fell apart. The deck felt did not feel that powerful in this one. Maybe you just need to get luckier with your opening ends. You need to get that fast mana going and the pressure going. Nonetheless, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you watched on YouTube, make sure to subscribe, and I'll see you next time.